After losing to the Detroit Pistons there last night in Detroit, the Raps head to Milwaukee to take on the Bucks. And the last time the Bucks played a basketball game, they slaughtered the Golden State Warriors. And the Raptors on the second night of a back-to-back, no Scottie Barnes, no Gary Trent Jr. It looks like it's going to be a real tough one today. And after an abysmal start, I believe it was a 16-3 start to the game, the Raptors end up winning this one 103-96. And they're now 21-19 on the year. They've won all three games against the Milwaukee Bucks at this point. Giannis did play in this one. And the boys did it on the road. Pascal Siakam, clutch. Chris Boucher knocked out a couple big shots. Heck of a job all around by the Toronto Raptors in this one. Let's break down this game. First quarter, as I mentioned, an abysmal start. You're down 29-20. After one quarter of playing, now considering you were down like 16-3, you did get it down to 9, but you're still down a good bit after one quarter of play. But in the second quarter, they continue that momentum, and they win the second quarter 26-20, and you're only down by 3 at halftime. The Raptors are right there. However, second night of a back-to-back, you've had to travel. It's the second half of the second night of a back-to-back. It's never an easy test. But damn it, do the Raptors come out in that second half and lay a beat down, but they come out with a purpose. And in that third quarter, they win it 27-20. And the Raptors go into the fourth quarter up by 4, looking to hang on to this win on the road in Milwaukee. I mean, it was not going to be easy. And it was back and forth in that fourth quarter until the Raptors started to make some big-time shots. One big play in the fourth quarter was OG Anunoby taking that step-back 3 contested. Now, it was at the end of the shot clock, goes off the rim and bounces basically right back to him. But OG follows his own rebound and goes up to the tin strong, gets the foul, and 1. And that was huge. Chris Boucher, how many times have we seen this guy just chuck up useless threes? Well, late in that fourth quarter, Boucher in the corner, pump fakes the 3, guy goes flying by. That looks like Boucher going flying by, but it was a role reversal here. Guy goes flying by Boucher, he just steps inside the 3-point line, gets that mid-range 2 from the corner, and knocks down the Jimmy like it's nothing. Heck of a job from him. Pascal Siakam making big shot after big shot in the dying minutes. Clutch. And we have not been able to say that a lot about Pascal Siakam over his young career with the Toronto Raptors. But let me rephrase that. Since before the bubble, right? We have not been able to say he's been clutch. He really wasn't last year. We all know that. In the bubble, he wasn't. And even to start this year, he hasn't really made the big shots late in the game. Tonight, a very, very different story from Pascal and the Toronto Raptors. Pascal with his second career triple-double, 30-10-10. The guy's playing out of his mind right now. He really, really is. And by the way, the Raptors win that fourth quarter 30-27. And they beat the Bucks 103-96. I want to get to a couple of quick stats. The Raptors held Giannis Antetokounmpo to 6-for-17. From the field. They held Chris Middleton to 3-of-12 from the field. They held the Bucks under 100 points. No Scottie, no Gary Trent Jr. And especially since what we witnessed there last night. That is the definition of a young squad. You're going to see games like yesterday, and you're going to see games like today, even on back-to-back nights. And you'll be like, damn, this is what this team is capable of. And that's what we saw today. Even Precious Achiuwa was fantastic tonight, and he's the first guy we're going to start with here. He had a double-double. 14-10-2 for Precious, 7-of-13 from the field, had a steal and 3 blocks in the game, and he was not forcing his shots. Now, he did take 3 threes, and I'd rather him not be doing that, but 7-of-13 from the field. And when it wasn't there, he's finding guys. I remember one play, he was driving to the tin. And we're so used to seeing him just kind of go up strong, but there's like 3 guys there and it just looks awful. But instead, a nice pass around the defender to a wide open Pascal in the corner for a mid-range jumper who knocks it down. And I'm like, whoa, Precious, that was a heads-up play. That was really nice. So a very good job for Precious Achiuwa in this game. He was active. He was efficient. Fantastic game for him. Pascal Siakam, easily the MVP in today's basketball game. Not only because of the triple-double, but the fact that he knocked down so many big shots in so many big moments in this game, 30, 10, and 10, shot 11 of 20 from the field, was 5 of 9 from the free throw line, so not great there. 3 of 3 from three-point range, hits 2 steals in the game today, and if there's anything to knock Pascal on today, which really there's not much, but I'm going to be nitpicky because, hey, this guy's been unbelievable. You got to find something he didn't do great. Obviously, the free throw shooting at 5 and 9, he did turn the ball over 6 times, but when you're giving me a triple-double and efficient and you win a game on the road against Milwaukee, I don't care how many turnovers you have. I really don't. So a heck of a game for Pascal. OG, 24 points, 8 boards, 4 dimes. Did shoot 9 of 23, was 3 of 5 from the line and 3 of 13 from 3. So obviously a lot of volume stuff for OG, but he did give you 24, 8 and 4. And I'll take that from the young OG. Great job from him. Fred VanVleet wasn't really the main face in the offense today. Obviously, a lot of OG, a lot of Spicy P. Even Achiuwa took 13 shots. Fred VanVleet, 17 points, 3 rebounds, 7 assists on 6 of 17 from the field. So kind of did struggle from the field. 2 of 4 from the line, 3 of 8 from 3-point range. Did shoot the ball well from 3. Had 3 steals in the game. Now let me get to some bench guys. Because we've talked about it all year long, how the Raptors bench really hasn't given you a whole lot. And obviously, Yuta Watanabe got the start, and in the very minimal minutes he played, he didn't do anything. He literally didn't do anything. So, you saw a lot of Chris Boucher, and he ended with 15.7 rebounds and assists on 6 of 12 shooting, was 1 of 2 from the free throw line, 2 of 5 from 3, and one of those two 3-point shots, I believe it was like a sidestep 3. And I'm like, who the heck is this guy shooting with confidence? Heck of a job for him. He had a steal and 3 denials. So a great job from Chris Boucher in this one. And I really believe that he's finding out what kind of player he is. As I mentioned before, he's not going to be a 30 and 15 type of guy all the time, right? He's not going to be that Defensive Player of the Year MVP that he was in the G League. You're not going to get that. But a 15 and 7, shoot 50%, knock down a couple threes, block shots off the bench. Yes, please. Heck of a game for Chris Boucher. And Justin Champagne played 30 minutes in the game, only had 3 points on 1 of 5 shooting, but the guy had 12 rebounds and an assist. 12! And he did knock down 1 of 2 from 3-point range. The 12 rebounds from him and the 7 from Boucher, you got 19 rebounds from those two bench guys. Incredible stuff from the Raptors tonight. They got a little bit of everything from everybody, and it was nice. Now, the team stats are pretty wild, but let's get to the percentages. Raptors shot 44% from the field, much better than yesterday's debacle. 34% from three-point range, better, still not great. But again, 34% from three, you'll take it. 55% from the free throw line. That just cannot happen. I think we're like 11 of 20. That cannot be happening. Pascal's 5 and 9. Where are we here? Fred, OG 3 of 5, Fred 2 of 4, you know, you gotta start knocking down your freebies, because in big moments, those could really kill you, as they did against the Phoenix Suns. So, you gotta start making those 55% for the Raptors in this one, not the greatest, but they did hold the Milwaukee Bucks to 34% from the field, 31% from 3, 91% from the free throw line, so they were good at the line when they got there. But from the field and three-point range, the Raptors just did a job. Did a job. And I'm so proud of these guys tonight, man. After what we talked about last night, now you're reading the comments saying this team is trash. They're awful. They won 6 in a row and then they lose a couple. Everyone thinks it's the end of the world and they're an absolute abomination of a team. They go out there tonight against Milwaukee, in Milwaukee, without Gary Trent, without Scotty, on the second night of a back-to-back, and you win. It's remarkable. It shows you the character of this squad. Now, let's get to these team stats. The Raptors were plus 10 on the glass, plus 7 on the offensive glass. They did a job. And a lot of credits to that, you know, Boucher and Champagne doing a job on the glass. Heck of a job from those two guys on the glass, all right? And plus 20 in points in the paint. The Raptors and the Bucks are two teams that love to keep teams out of the paint. Well, the fact that the Raptors full-on dominated the paint in this one tells you the better team was. Plus 20 in the points in the paint category. Second chance points off of those plus 7 on the offensive boards. Plus 14 in second chance points, and then points off of turnovers. The Raptors were plus 6 in most points off of turnovers. So they did a job tonight. They kept Giannis quiet as best they could. They kept Middleton quiet as best they could. And they forced other guys to full-on beat them, and they did. The Raptors did a fantastic job. Now, it doesn't get any easier, though, as in you get a couple days off. You get tomorrow off. Before you take on the Miami Heat in Miami. Yeah, Raptor fans. All the boys go down to Miami to take on Kyle Lowry and the Miami Heat. Obviously, Kyle's not going to be here. He won't be here until the beginning of February. And there probably won't be any fans. We're just going to be god-awful. But at least we're going to be able to see Kyle. Unfortunately, Miami Heat uniform. And it's going to break us to see it live against our guys. And hugging Pascal and hugging all these guys. And I'll be sitting here like, I hate this so much. But let's see what these guys can do against one of the better teams in the Eastern Conference. They did a great job tonight against Milwaukee. Let's see what they can do against Miami in Miami. That's a Monday night 7:30 tip-off, all right? So you know what, guys? That is going to do it for this one. If you enjoyed the video and enjoyed the game this evening, smack the like button to appreciate that. Hit the subscribe button if you're not already. Comment down below. Thoughts on the video, thoughts on the game. Would you like, would you not like from today's game today for the Toronto Raptors? Twitter link is down below, so follow up. Send me a DM to that great stuff. The Instagram link is also down below, so follow up. If you guys have not done so already. And I will talk to you guys Leafs Nation very shortly. They won 6-5 tonight over St. Louis in a wild one in St. Louis, Missouri. All right? And as for the Toronto Raptors, their next contest, as we mentioned, is in Miami on Monday night. 7:30 tip-off there as Raptors look for back-to-back Ws and to go 3 games over .500 now. So wouldn't that be nice to get back to that 3 games over .500 and look to keep building on it and to face and beat a really good team in Miami, all right? So thank you guys so much for listening and watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. We'll talk to you guys then.